niin kuin veli Oskari juuri äsken sanoi. Jos me joudumme nyt tällä hetkellä Jumalan
eteen.
Että me olemme Jumalalle
kelvolliset.
Ja Jumalan edessä puhta.
And here before God. Veli Oskari Vartilas.
Minä haluan vaan muutamaan sanaa.
I want to say a few words.
Olimme tuolla Minneapolisin seuroissa.
We were at the services in Minneapolis.
Ja veli Petaisto oli siellä.
And brother Petaisto was there.
Ja hän teki parannusta väärästä hengestä.
And he made a repentance of a false spirit.
Ja sanoi astuvansa puhujan paikalta sivuun.
And he said he's going to step down to the side from
here. Ja nämä kaikki tulivat teille.
And all of this came upon teille.
Minä vain yhtenä kristittynä ihmettelen.
I as one Christian marvel or wonder.
Miksi kristityn pitää olla yksi kerta näin ja toisin kerran näin.
Ei
voi olla suora ja rehellinen joka puolella.
Why a Christian has to be one this way and then next time that way? Why can't he be firm and straight?
Ja josta tavallisesti kalinat kuuluu perää, siinä on syy.
And when there is a spalling or murmuring here and there, there is fault here, there is a reason.
Niin tässä muistan tosiaan
viime
sunnuntaina, kun olin kaikkiaan noita sille anteeksi jättämisessä veressä. Ja kaikki olisi pitänyt unohtaa, eikä enää muin jälleen muistaa.
Mikä se koko, oliko se kesäkuun
20?
En minä tiedä
sitä, mutta
kyllä
nämä lujit sieltä juttiin se.
Tässä on nyt
kirja tullut itse. Joo, ja kaikki on annettu anteeksi. Ja se on kauheampana nyt vain huohu. Eihän ne koskaan anteeksi, eikä anteeksi
antanut
ollenkaan. Mitä se meinaa sitten, se anteeksi antanut? Ei mitään. Ja silloin mitä kertaa? Ei koskaan siihen jälkeitä muuta kuin aina vain edes mennään ja edes mennään aina vain.
Your brothers in faith, not peace. It was the decision of the Board of Trustees of the Eastern Congregation that the following information concerning this Petaisto could be presented to the Mission Board. On June 10, 1972, the Eastern Congregation held a special meeting concerning this Petaisto. At this meeting, the congregation accepted his resignation as our pastor, and therefore he would not represent our congregation as a member of the Mission Board. Any opinions expressed by him will be strictly personal and not the opinions of the Mission Board. The following is an excerpt from the minutes of our special meeting. This was repented of having a false spirit and promised to stop preaching here and would only fulfill his commitment to the other congregation. God's peace. Theodore Hummel, the chairman, Frank Hummel, the junior secretary.
Does that sound like the incoming congregation has forgiven the Petaisto?
I have a letter from the Mission Board that I'd like to read.
It stated
on June 19, operating on appeal.
Article 6 of the minutes of the Apostolic Lutheran Mission Board held on January 8, 1971. When the discussion took place on the power and authority that has been delegated to the Apostolic Lutheran Mission regarding the keeping of services and the use of speakers by congregations which are affiliated with the Commission. It was a unanimous decision by show of hands vote of the board members present that the mission does not have the authority to tell any congregation which speaker can or cannot be used, but that it is the right of each individual congregation to decide, according to their bylaws, who they want their resident minister to be, and also which other speakers will be used in their congregation. Your congregation has received a copy of the minutes of the annual meeting of the mission held on June 12, 1971, where the motion, Article 8, was made and approved that in order to restore peace, that for some time the mission board will not request Mr. Petaisto for mission work. However, filing with this motion was another one, which was also approved, stating that individual congregations are left with the freedom to call us to preach and keep services for them if they desire to do so. Article 6 of the minutes of the Apostolic Lutheran Mission Board held on September 24, 1971, a lengthy discussion on matters pertaining to Christianity took place. The thinking of a church board of trustees was brought up that inasmuch as Mr. Petaisto is not doing mission work at the present time, perhaps he should not serve on the mission board as the regional director. Again, it was stated with all members present in approval that the central board does not have any control over this matter. It is a matter for the annual meeting for the congregation which he represents as regional director to decide. On a motion made, seconded, and approved by all members present, the board decided that all paid proceedings, all paid recordings of Finland's SRK meeting with Mr. Petaisto rightfully should be in the possession of the central board. Up to this time, June 1972, none of the tapes which have been circulating around the country have been sent to the mission board. Article 4 of the minutes of the joint meeting of the Apostolic Lutheran Mission Board and the issuing Apostolic Lutheran Congregation Board. A lengthy discussion took place on matters pertaining to Mr. Petaisto. The discussion concluded with the issuing Congregation Board of Directors and the Mission Board coming to a mutual, unanimous decision and understanding that it would be in the best interests and well-being of Christianity if for a time until peace is restored, Cusco would only continue to serve those congregations which he now serves on a regular basis. He promised to abide by and take heed of this decision and refuse any request for services in congregations or localities where he does not at the present time keep services regular. I hope that the above excerpts of the minutes of the meeting of the mission board will clarify and notify him as to the present official status of the mission board pertaining and relating to Mr. Petaisto. God peace, Albert Carney, the secretary.
And the reason I wrote that letter is I the Finnish congregation wrote, and then it was sent to Ruth's office and she reported to me. Ruth's office, 1972, Apostolic Lutheran Mission, 120 Public Street, Florida, Michigan. God's peace. We the faithful of the church board held our monthly meeting Monday tonight in a motion of tag and invite the rest of the mission board stating that we would like a letter from them giving us the reason for this we cannot speak in the church. So we can act on whether we will change this ministry. God's peace, Santana, and the secretary. Okay, I just took excerpts from our different minutes of different meetings that we've had for the last couple of years. Minutes that pertain to the spoken matter.
That's the ordinance of conduct.
Just so I have the knowledge of this letter from the mission board. Brother Ray Miskander.
No. minä minustakin tuntuu, ja saanko minä nyt sanoa usko, näin, minä uskallan kysyä tämän seurakunnan. Ja uskallatko sinä lyhyesti vastata minun kysymykseen tämän
seurakunnan?
Ja syy, miksi minä haluan vastata sen, on, että ne, jotka sinua on kannattanut, näkis, mistä ne on sinua kannattanut.
And the reason for this is that those who have supported you will see the reason why they have been supporting you.
Teitkö sinä parannuksen eri hengestä, Minia?
Did you make repentance of the false spirit in Minneapolis?
I ask forgiveness in here, the false spirit in Minneapolis, and I answered Oscar Karsika's question. He said that I did something different that I promised. I said that I go to every congregation and ask to leave me as a listener, but this promise is subject to the congregation because I understand, and it was understood before, that we obey the God's word and His congregation. This reason I put this subject to the congregation, this promise. Then, as I told them, if someone vote me in or come to listening me, as I personally have something that they trust only me and follow me, they are wrong. But if we go to services, we should go to listening what the Spirit speaks through the congregation. And all my life in here in the United States, as well as also in Finland, I have been among of the Christians. But 4 years I while I was in business, I myself quit because my conscience wasn't clean. And 4 years I was without speaking in Finland. Reason I know my conscience wasn't clean. And now when my sins are forgiven and I have righteousness through faith in Lord Jesus, in His kingdom, well as every one of you, I just don't believe as you also have to leave yourself for God's hand, according to His word and according to His kingdom, His communication. They take care of us as a mother take care of faith. I want to live, and I hope you keep me as a little baby, and take care of me, and whenever you see I am wrong, you correct me, and whenever I ask forgiveness, you can bless me and forgive me. And so also I want myself remember you will take care of me.
Brother Heikki Saari has suggested that
Petaisto olisi saanut oikean parannuksen arvon ja hengen muutoksen uudistetun hengen.
Petaisto would have received a true repentance and a renewed spirit. The swabbling around him would have ceased. For the Holy Spirit doesn't swabble or argue in congregation. It is always a foreign spirit that argues in the congregation.
Toinen henki tuo aina kiivaa liitelevän hengen, ja se on aina persoonan päällä.
The foreign spirit always brings with it a very zealous sense of argument, and it is always centered on a person.
Nämä hedelmät ovat olleet ennen Suomeen lähtöä Petäistön.
These fruits have been in Petäistö before he left from Finland.
Petäistön kohdalla ja vieläkin ja.
In Petäistö's life and they are still continuing.
Niin se on selvä, että miehet ei ole tapahtunut minkäänlaista muuta.
Kyllä Jumalan seurakunnassa on anteeksi antanut ja riidat loppuvat, kun asiat oikein korjataan.
In the congregation of God there is forgiveness and this bubbling will cease when matters are corrected.
Mutta jos sitä sinikellään ja puolustellaan ja tasotellaan, niin kuin tätäkin tapauksessa on tapahtunut, niin riita aina ja...
But if the matters are smoothed over and... This meeting has revealed that Petaisto has had no change. And there appears that when there is something from debate that the matter is solved, I agree with old Hakso's suggestion that you supporters make repentance.
On Jumalan seurakunnan kehoitus, Hakson ääni.
The voice of Hakso has been the encouraging voice of the congregation of God.
Now in our country it's a democracy and each congregation is a
They're in Michigan and they're incorporated. Each separate congregation, and they do not have to look to the mission to supply them with the minister. They will pick their minister. It's separate from in Finland. That is not that we are America, they are Finland.
Are you referring to the state church?
No, I am referring to the Rauhan Baptist who's selling these ministers, their preachers around. And I imagine they do have tab on them. But our mission does, as far as the congregations who have no preachers, they will send to them, but they don't have to send to Calumet, they don't have to send to Detroit. Unless Detroit calls one of these people.
There are a lot of congregations in America that are not given the opportunity of listening to having a president speaker. They're dependent on the mission.
That's right.
Suomessa on siis käytäntö ollut tämmöinen, in Finnish they have used this method, että jos esimerkiksi jossakin seurakunnassa tulee pahoja erimielisyyksiä.
And that, for example, in some congregation, they have different understandings.
Ja ne eivät pääse yksimielisyyteen.
And they cannot come into the same line on these matters.
Niin ne kääntyy sen keskusyhtyyteen johtokunnan puoleen.
Then they turn on the door.
Ja se lähettää veljiä niitä auttamaan, kuulemaan molemman puolen kiusaukset ja murheet ja vaivat ja pyhän hengen ja sanan valossa antamaan jumalaisia neuvoja.
And that Lord sends brothers there to instruct them and teach them according to the word of God and according to the Holy Spirit.
Että jonkinlainen tällainen järjestely olisi tarpeen täälläkin.
That some such like organization would also be necessary here.
Mutta niin kuin sanottu, tästä on puhuttu aikaisemminkin, siis tämän johtokunnan laajentamisessa.
But as Justin said, we've spoken before about this, broadening this organization or board.
Ja sitä on laajennettu.
And it has been broadened.
Mutta se on yksi vaikeus, nuo pitkät matkat täällä, että siinä on kysymystä kerran sitten, miten se sitten käytännössä hoidettaisiin.
But there is one difficulty, these long distances. How can it really be put to use?
Että minä ymmärsin, että Heikki esitti sitä, että
I understand that Nathan suggested,
että tällaisen niin kuin Minneapolis seurakunnan esitys ja muita tulee, niin
that this suggestion brought by Minneapolis.
Olisi tarpeellista monistaa ja lähettää ne seurakunnille, että ne saisi siellä rauhassa tutkia ja
it would be important to repeat them and send them out to the other congregations so they might be able to study them.
Sitten ne paremmin voisi sanoa jotakin täälläkin. Se on yhtäkkiä tuommoisia tuodaan, niin se on vähän vaikea.
It would be better for them to discuss them here even. But when they come all of a sudden like this, it's very hard to discuss them.
What's the proposal?
He didn't make any proposal.
He referred to what I had suggested, that the matter be sent to each individual congregation for study. You speak on that tonight, please raise your hand so then, Brother Arnold.
What matter are you going to bring to the congregations? Who's going to write this? Or are you going to just present the letter that Minneapolis has?
The proposal that was read should be duplicated or made copies of and sent to the various congregations. This was my suggestion.
Mr. Chairman, would the Commission Committee broaden on that and explain that more thoroughly in the letter that you issued to me every 3 months in regards to the minutes and then the batch of copy of that, what kind of an answer you would like at a certain time. You would elaborate on what kind of answer you want. But
yes,
that's the other question, really is.
This is probably be something about the formal suggestion that there has been commission board send out with their annual 2 minutes of the meetings, copy of this and anything else that they wish to elaborate on, this will be considered.
Brother mentioned here that is it understood that each congregation that has a certain number of people that they send, there's been three to send someone to the mission meeting that you had 33 months or so. They said that they haven't got an answer. If they want an answer, but they send somebody there to bring the issue up for you.
When you're speaking about the additional members, the board members?
Right, the additional board members that each congregation has chosen.
Yes, I'd like to clear that up. Mr. Lopez, I mentioned many of the committee information. Lori Hakso is a useful member in that area, and he gets a copy of every meeting that we have, the minutes of every meeting.
He's
free to
come, right?
Yes, right. We notify the meeting people in advance, and then he gets a copy of the
minutes. Well, in most cases, why don't those people write back to you if they have something to comment on? You don't get letters.
Nämä esittäisiin edelleen. nämä suomaveljetkin vastaavat siihen, että saa
well, you know, these Finland brothers might be able to answer on it. And everyone.
I understand that the performance or duty of the SRK in Finland to be such. Ettei läheskään kaikkia asioita, mitä se keskustelee kristillisyyden asioista ja pohjoista, niitä ei lähetetä kaikille sellaista.
Not nearly all of the matters that are there discussed, they are not sent to the all the congregations to be read.
Eikä se ole saari näin. Ja statistics, so, sorry, this is yes. Ja periaate tässä varmaan on siis se,
the main thought here must certainly be this,
mitä Jeesus sanoo kirkkolaissaan.
Which Jesus says in the church law.
Että puhuttelee ensin kahden kesken,
that first review,
kolmen kesken,
and then three.
Ja ellei se sitä sen tottele, ilmoita sitten seuraavaksi.
And if he's not obedient on this, then make it known out of the congregation.
Että jos kaikki, mitä missä kohdilla johtuna, kaikki asiat aina levitettäisiin kaikkiin seuraavaksi.
If all these matters of the mission board being spread into all the congregations.
Niin minä ajattelen, että se synnyttäisi enääntä levottomuutta.
I am thinking that it would bring about more restlessness.
Että kyllä sillä pitäisi oikeus olla joitakin käsitellä semmoiset, jotta se ymmärtää, että hän voi ne hoitaa niin, ettei tarvitse kaikkea yrittää kaikkea seurakuntaan.
And if you have a right, this mission board should have a right, and if they think that these matters are able to be handled by the mission board, but then they should not be spread to the other congregations.
Mutta sitten on toinen kiusaus ja vaara.
But then there's another temptation and danger.
Että mission board ja tämä johtava elin voi
the mission board and this guiding board
mennä siihenkin heikkouteen ja kiusaukseen.
You can come out of this weakness and temptation.
Että taas sen teittää ja kätkää liian paljon niitä asioita.
That then they can again hide and keep too much of these matters,
jotka on tarpeellista antaa tietää seuraavaksi.
Which would be necessary to let the congregation know that this is also a temptation on the other side.
What are we trying to form here in the form of Christianity? Vatican, despite the fact that they have a governing body in Rome that tells them what they have to do. The congregations don't have very much to say in their own behalf. Is this what we want?
No.
This is what it's going to work out to be. We're going to give the mission board the authority to tell these small congregations, for instance, what they can do. The small congregations won't have a thing to say in their own behalf. They listen to the mission board. This is what the Vatican is doing to their congregations. They tell them what to do. They don't have any voice.
I'm afraid that isn't the intention of this at all. This is just a matter that if a small congregation has a problem, that they read some place to turn. It isn't a
Yeah.
one thing that came to my mind, and I'm just wondering, would this be a representative of one from each congregation, or would it be determined on the number of people in your congregation in this matter? Would that be one from each, or would it be, say, like four or five from another?
One from each.
This is the matter that I think, that if you have one from each congregation, I think that it would be more, to my knowledge anyway, I think it would be more fair. Then each one would have the same amount of power, you might say, regarding that question. Now, I know that Ishpeming congregation has had a big... We've had a matter here that exploded all over the United States and Canada here. And if this matter had been able to have been handled from the time that we first took hold of it with the mission board over here, and it went to Finland, and when it come back from there, it would have been taken care of there, and not have to take and be blown all over, this thing would have been settled today, and there would have been peace and quiet in this congregation. If we would have had a board here, brothers and sisters, or brothers here that would have represented these congregations and taken care of that matter right here. Isn't that right?
Reason
from Finland, they shouldn't take care of their customers. But the 3 years ago, the Finland brothers were asked about the feeling of Finland in respect to the new translation of the Bible. I forgot this instruction. And I said, expressed my feelings.